Dear learner, Namaskar. I, Naipal Singh, welcome you to the program of Library and Information Science at Senior Secondary level. In the last program, we discussed different types of information sources. In today's program, we shall discuss reference sources. If you have visited a library, you might have noticed that there is a reference section in the library where reference sources are arranged. Reference sources. As you know that a reference source provides answer to brief facts, statistical information, background information, or direct you to the additional information source. Although the term reference book is frequently used for reference sources, but reference sources may be books, serial, online databases, or other sources available on the internet. Reference books are referred or consulted only and not meant for continuous reading. For example, you normally use a dictionary to find out meaning of a word. You do not read it page by page as you do with a textbook or a storybook. Reference sources include dictionaries, encyclopedias, handbooks, yearbooks, almanacs, directories, biographical and geographical sources. Let us start with the dictionary. Dictionary. A modern dictionary is a book containing words of a language arranged alphabetically with their meanings. Most dictionaries tell us much more than meaning of the words. Many list pronunciation, grammatical labels, illustrative quotations, synonyms, antonyms, usage notes, and other information. Some dictionaries include etymology and history of the words. Examples of dictionaries are the Chambers Dictionary, Oxford Dictionary, etc. Types of dictionaries. Based on the number of words, scope and coverage of the other item of information, the dictionaries can be categorized into general language dictionaries, subject dictionaries, special purpose dictionaries, and bilingual and multilingual dictionaries. Now we come to general language dictionaries. General language dictionaries cover all the words of a language and give meanings, definition, and explanation of words in the same language. These dictionaries are also called monolingual dictionaries. General language dictionary can be further subdivided according to size and target user group. According to size, general language dictionaries may be comprehensive, unabridged, abridged, college desk, or pocket dictionary. The example of these types of dictionaries are Merriam-Webster College Dictionaries, Merriam-Webster School Dictionary, Merriam-Webster Pocket Dictionary. Now we come to subject dictionaries. Subject dictionaries provide the definition of the term in a given subject. Subject dictionaries are becoming increasingly common due to increase in study and research in different subject areas ranging from social science to science and technology. For example, McGraw-Hill Dictionary of Scientific and Technical Term is a subject dictionary. Now we come to special dictionaries. The special dictionaries deal with special types or special aspect of the word. Special types of class of word include obsolete words, acronyms, abbreviation, etc. Special aspect of the word includes linguistic aspect of the word such as pronunciation, synonyms and antonyms, etc. or literary aspect of the word such as quotations, idioms, proverbs, etc. Example of special dictionaries are Cambridge English Pronouncing Dictionary, Cambridge Idioms Dictionary, the Oxford Dictionary of Quotations. Bilingual and multilingual dictionaries. The bilingual dictionaries give meaning of a word from one language to another language. For example, an English-Hindi dictionary will list words in English and give equivalent words in Hindi. This type of dictionary is called a bilingual dictionary. A multilingual dictionary gives the meaning of a word in more than two languages. These dictionaries are also called translating dictionaries. Oxford University Press brings out a number of bilingual and multilingual dictionaries. Example of bilingual and multilingual dictionaries are Concise Oxford Spanish Dictionary, Multilingual Biomedical Technical Dictionary, Subdukos English Hindi Dictionary. The www.shabdkosh.com website provides English to Hindi as well as Hindi to English translation. Now we come to encyclopedia. Encyclopedia is a book or set of books giving information on all branches of knowledge or on certain wide field with article arranged alphabetically. An encyclopedia contains information about peoples, palaces, events, and things. It may deal with all areas of knowledge or it may be limited to just one subject area. A general encyclopedia includes information on topics in every field of knowledge, whereas specialized encyclopedia provide more detailed and technical information on a specific area of knowledge, such as arts, science and technology, or social sciences. Specialized encyclopedia is also known as subject encyclopedia. Types of encyclopedias. Encyclopedia can be broadly divided into two types, general encyclopedia and subject encyclopedia. General encyclopedia can be further categorized on the basis of size, single volume or multi-volume. Target user, adults, students or children. Most of the publisher of general encyclopedias brings out different sets of encyclopedias for adults, students and children of various age group. Articles in children encyclopedia are written in simple language and with illustration to make the topic clear and understandable. Encyclopedia Britannica is a general encyclopedia in English language published by Encyclopedia Britannica. It contains articles on different topics. The articles are aimed at educated adults and are written by about 100 full-time editors and more than 4,000 experts contributors. It is 32 volume set. Single volume Britannica is a concise encyclopedia which has 28,000 short articles condensing to the larger 32 volume Britannica. Britannica Student Encyclopedia. The 16 volume Britannica Student Encyclopedia has more than 2300 articles with 33,000 photos, illustrations, charts, tables to make it appealing and useful to students. The encyclopedia has 1,000 maps and flags of various countries of the world. Recent advance in information technology and rise of electronic encyclopedias such as Microsoft Encarta and Wikipedia has reduced the demand for printed encyclopedia. The publisher of Encyclopedia Britannica has developed electronic version of encyclopedia on CD-ROMs, DVD and World Wide Web. Encyclopedia Britannica Online contains the text of 32 volume Encyclopedia Britannica plus additional article and images which are not available in the print set. It has more than 120,000 articles. It is also available at www.britannica.com. Subject Encyclopedias. Subject Encyclopedia provides detailed information on a specific area of knowledge such as arts, science and technology, social sciences, etc. Example of subject encyclopedias are McGraw-Hill Encyclopedia of Science and Technology, McGraw-Hill Concise Encyclopedia of Science and Technology, Encyclopedia of Library and Information Science, edited by Alan Kent and published by Mark L. Decker. Now we come to yearbook. Yearbook. Yearbook is a book of information that is updated and published annually, that is every year. The basic purpose of a yearbook is to record events and developments of the previous year in a country or in the world. Based on their scope and type of information covered, yearbooks can be categorized as international yearbook, national yearbook, subject yearbook. International yearbook. International yearbook provides reliable and handy statistical information about each country of the world. For example, the Statesman yearbook is an international yearbook. National yearbook. National yearbook provides up-to-date political, economic and social account of an individual country. National yearbooks are mostly compiled by respective government of that country and considered reliable and authoritative. For example, India A Reference Annual is a national yearbook published by Publication Division, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. Subject yearbook. Yearbook devoted to specific subject or group of subject is called a subject yearbook. McGraw-Hill Yearbook of Science and Technology is a subject yearbook. Now we come to almanac. An almanac is a reference book usually published once a year and contains many kinds of information. Almanacs originally provided a calendar of months with eclipse, the movement of planets, and the rising and setting of sun, moon, and stars. Present-day almanacs include a comprehensive presentation of statistical and descriptive data covering the entire world. Examples of almanacs are World Almanac and Books of Facts, published annually in USA by Barnes & Noble. The second example is Whitaker's Almanacs, published annually in UK by A&C Black Publishers. Handbook. The literal meaning of term handbook is a book which is handy to use as it contains useful facts and is convenient to carry. Handbook can be defined as a concise reference book providing specific information or instruction about a topic or a subject. A subject handbook basically provides brief factual information on a subject. It is so designed that it can be easily consulted and provide quick answers. Handbooks are widely used by practitioners and specialists working in an industry or a laboratory. CRC Press brings out a large number of handbooks for practitioners. Some of the examples are Handbook of Chemistry and Physics. Manual. The term manual is derived from Latin term manuals, meaning a guidebook. A manual basically provides step-by-step instruction on how to do a particular job or operate a particular machine. When you buy any home appliances such as television, an air conditioner, an oven, or even a mobile phone, you are provided with a manual which gives proper instruction on how to use that appliances. For example, a cookbook is a manual. Directory. Directories are also very important reference tools in a library to answer different types of inquiries from the users. Directories can be broadly categorized as general directories, special directories. General directories. A telephone directory comes under the category of general directories. You must be familiar with telephone directory. Every city in a country has a telephone directory which provides information about telephone numbers and address of subscribers. These directories are usually compiled by post and telegraph departments. Special directories. Directories of organizations are called special directories and can be broadly grouped into three types. Directories of academic and research institutions, professionals directories, and trade and business directories. Directories of academic institutions list institutions of higher education and learning such as universities and colleges. Under each academic institution, information regarding the type of courses and facilities offered, eligibility criteria, names of the senior staff, member, etc. are provided. These directories may be international or national in coverage. For example, the Europa World of Learning is an international directory and University's Handbook is a national directory. Professional directories. There are thousands of societies and associations in the world in almost every significant field of knowledge. Members of these associations are scholars in their respective areas of specialization. These associations also compile directories listing details of their members. Trade and business directories provide information about trade, business, and industries. For example, Kothari Industrial Directory of India, published by Kothari Enterprises, is an example of trade and business directories. Now we come to geographical information sources. Geographical information sources include maps, atlases, globes, gazetteers, and guidebooks. These sources provide information about places, people, river, mountain, forest, lakes, etc. Library maintain geographical information sources in their reference collection to meet information needs of the user quickly. This type of collection includes three types of sources: maps, atlases and globes, gazetteers, and guidebooks. Maps, atlases and globes. Map is a pictorial presentation of Earth's surface or part of it, showing countries, cities, rivers, lakes, and mountains. A map can also be drawing of the sky, showing the position of stars and the planets. Types of maps. There are many types of maps. The most familiar types are general reference maps and thematic maps. Gazetteers. A gazetteer is a dictionary of geographical names. It lists names of palaces, cities, mountains, and other geographical entities of a particular area, along with its history, economic development, geography, and the people. As a reference source, a gazetteer provides historical, social, cultural, political, industrial, demographic, and administrative detail of a country, state, or a district. Based on their coverage, gazetteer can be categorized into international gazetteer, national gazetteer, and local gazetteer. Example of international gazetteer is Merriam-Webster Geographical Dictionary. Gazetteer of India is a national gazetteer, and Haryana District Gazetteer is a district gazetteer. Biographical information sources. Biographical sources are publication listing biographical detail of famous people. A biographical source may contain a biography of an individual or biographies of a group of people called collective biographies. A book containing collective biography is also called biographical dictionary. For example, the Dictionary of International Biography. A biographical source may be international or national in scope, depending upon the coverage of persons. Some biographical sources deal with living persons only, that is who's who, while some contain persons who are no longer living, that is who was who. Some sources include life sketch of both living and dead persons, that is Webster Biographical Dictionary. Some example of biographical sources are Who's Who in the World. The publication is also available online. General biographical sources, India's Who Who, published by Infa Publication. Dear learners, we have discussed in today's program different types of reference sources, that is dictionaries, encyclopedias, directories, maps, and biographical sources. I hope that today's program will be helpful to you to understand better the different types of reference sources. Thanks for watching this program. We shall meet in the next program with another topic. Thank you.